the different parameters, and then the program itself, they will take care of the calculating the loads. Then so that was about defining, and then if you come down, we can define the load cases and load combinations. That is different load combinations. That is how we have to make the cases there. Then the next is draw. So we can use the floor beams, the floor itself, the walls, columns, anything. We just have to go. So we can do it from here. Different options. Or all the drawing options are on the left hand side, the vertical there. So we can just draw whether it's beam, column, where we want to draw it in plan, or whether we want to draw it in an elevation, or so we have to draw from there. So the first one there, that's a beam. Second one is that's a beam as well, but that's a quick one. So it will pick the two grids, and between the two grids, it will just draw. The next one is the column. So when we are trying to draw a column in plan, so we are just in the plan, and we just wherever we want, we just draw. And what VTF does, it always draws below the level that we are working in. So if we are on third floor, for example, we have a building, we are in this floor. If I'm drawing here, the ETF will draw that column below that level, rather than above. So it will draw below. I'll show you that in the thing. So these are different functions, drawing functions that we can use either from there or either from draw up here. Then the next one is select. So you want to select. In the select, in ETF is a powerful software, so you can choose you can go in different functions. You can choose by type. For example, you want to choose the columns, you want to choose the beams, you want to choose the slabs, or you want to choose by section. Let's say how many 250 UVs I have, or how many 400 by 400 columns do I have. So just choose that section type, and in the entire model, it will choose that all the sections, and then you can delete or whatever, you can change it to another section, whatever you want to do. So you can do it from this. So see, select, and there is different. So see, object type, property types, group types, story, you can choose in a story, whatever you like, you can do it from there. Then the next one is assign. So in assign, the first one is, we have to assign some properties or some, different limitations or restrictions to different joints, elements. So the first one is the joint. For example, on the ground, we can define whether it's a pin connection, fixed connection, whatever it is, we can just provide those restraints from that one. We can apply springs, diaphragm, panel zone, different things. Then frame. So if we go to the frame, from the frame we can choose the frame member, we can change the section, we can assign different section, we can assign the release, whether it's a pin, whether it's a continue beam, whatever it is, we can just assign those properties. Similarly, from the shell, we can assign wall section, slab section to certain floors or certain walls. We can assign different sections that we have defined, so we can change. Then lengths, similarly, then the next one is down there is loads. So, I mean, other than what the model only can pick the self-weight. It can calculate the self-weight. The model don't know what else is there. So all the live load, the superimposed load, what we need to do? We have to define. We have to assign. So once we define our load cases, then we have to choose the members that we want to assign the load. We choose it, select it, and we come here. Whether the load is applied to a joint. If we want a load at a joint, we can select the joint and assign the loads. Is it a frame? If it's a beam and we want to apply a UDL or point load, then we go to the frame. If it's a shell, for example, the entire slab. This building here, I'm modeling and up to the top floor, I'm trying to apply live load. So what I have to do, select the floor and assign load and live load, how many kPa it is, doesn't matter, I just have to assign, and then the program will distribute that load to all the members, columns, itself. Then the next one is analysis. So we just have to leave that at the default. and just run the analysis. This one here, this will be the one we're using. And then this is block model, unlock model. So if the model is blocked, that means the analysis is there. As soon as you unlock the model, the analysis is gone. The model, you have to rerun the model. Okay? Then display, different display settings. From there you can see, you know, you can try to switch between bending moment, shear forces, all the different stresses. That's you switch from there. From here on, the design part, we're not gonna be using it, but you can use ETAP to design all the different sections for you. Steel, concrete, whatever, to the standard, the current standard, whether you are in America, Europe, or New Zealand, it will use the New Zealand standard. In New Zealand, it will use the New Zealand standard to design the steel, concrete, or whatever you like. But we are doing that. Again, detailing, then you can detail in ETAP, based on all, and then it can give you some drawings. And then options, from options you can go to different settings. We're not going to go into too much into that, otherwise we'll be running short of time. And then of course help. So if you go to the help section, over there you can find the ETAP manual, all the PDF document, I think it's 700 something pages, you know, where it gives you all this information about the ETAP, how to operate it. Then the bottom one, again, these are then function, it's exactly the same thing, it wasn't part of those toolbars, but you know, in here, some of them are again, there is open, knee model, save, and then lock, run, there is zoom in, zoom out, three, these are the, you know, view, 3D view, plan view elevation, and this is something, you know, this is like Google. So what if you can see the kind of the whole thing, you know, it's a 3D, you can see from two sides, but when you click on it, it will give you a different view. This one here, the arrows are switching between, if you are on plan, if your view is on plan view, it will switch between different plans. If you are on elevation, it will switch between different elevations and different grids, grid 1, 2, 3, or A, B, C, and vice versa. Then this one here is, again, if you want to toggle or shrink, or this one here is display setting. So if you click on it, you get this table. Then in here, if you go to object, you can choose. You can choose from these different, you can see like on the left, the joint label, you click the label, it will show you the label. So in the model, you will see all the labels. You can see the, then coming down to the shell, different options, you can choose if you want to see what section it is or what slab type it is. Then on the right hand side, that's for the frame. So you can again put the label, put the section size, and if you will see those. And you simply need to hit apply. And then other assignment, that is the pier level. So if you want, you know, all the walls that you have modeled, you can come here and just make sure you click, and then it will show you the wall or spandrels or anything that will give you the labels. Then in here, this will give you, you can, you know, if you are the deflected shaft, and if you want to switch, or any diagram, any moment, you know, shear forces, anything, you click on this, it will just give you the normal building look. It will take up all the other design action. These ones here, this is for display the joint loads. The next one, if you want to see, you know, what are the joint loads, so you click on that, and then you can choose the case, what case you want. Similarly, this is for a frame. If you want to see on the beams, what is the load you have assigned in any elevation, you click on that, and then I'll just, for example, I'll click on it, and see here. So then, I mean, currently I just have those two cases, and I don't have any frames, otherwise it will give me the option. You click on that, apply, you will see all the loads assigned. And then the next one here is the shell, that's for the shell, and then this is for the deflected shaft. Currently we don't have anything, but once we have the model and it is run, then we will be able to see. The next one here, there is the joint reactions. Currently we don't have anything, but once we have a model, then we, you know, and it's run, then we can see the best reactions using that option. This one here, is there is the bending moment diagrams for all the beams, columns, so we can see it through that function there. And then this one is the shell. So the display the shell stresses, shell means the floors, the walls, you can go and display the stresses, internal stresses, that what are the stresses in those members. And this side here again is for the design.